Ben Simmons is one of the most talented players around the NBA. However, he's also drawn plenty of criticism for the way he handled the situation with the Philadelphia 76ers. That's why today, we're going to let you know what these 7 NBA players think of him. Number 7, LeBron James. LeBron James sure knows a thing or two about criticism. He's been called out and pointed out throughout his entire career, with people looking down on him even when he's winning. That's why with him also being represented by Clutch Sports and Rich Paul, he's offered Simmons some friendly advice throughout the years. He worked his tail off. The sky's the limit for Ben. His size, his strength, his vision, his IQ. He carries himself as someone who believes he's the best, as you should. As long as he doesn't care about what other people say, he'll be fine, James claimed. 9 times out of 10, people who criticize you have never done anything in their life. Either that or they're jealous because you're better than them, LeBron said. Notably, Simmons drew plenty of comparisons to LeBron James before entering the league, which is unsurprising given his rare combination of size and playmaking skills. And while Simmons is already a better, or at least more versatile defender than LeBron James, the King clearly is a far superior offensive player. Number 6, Shaquille O'Neal. Shaquille O'Neal is often ruthless towards young players, but he actually took some time to give Simmons some guidance. Clearly, he thinks he's just too good, but not exactly a hard worker. And the fact that he's often showing off his rich and famous lifestyle doesn't do much to help his case. That's why Shaq urged him to stop showing off and stick to working on his craft. When I work out hard. I'm not like some players from Philadelphia that don't work on their game. I always work on my game. I'm just playing. I have a lot of thoughts. But I know we're blessed to do what we do. Whether you like it or not, you have responsibility. When you and me had our first debate, our first arguments, you told me that you said, Shaq, you're pretty good, but in order to be great, you gotta work on your game, get to the next level. And what did I do after that? I said, okay, you've been criticizing me, you've been doing your job, because I wasn't doing my job. I didn't want to fight you and punch you in your face. We had a conversation man to man. You're a good player, I'm not knocking that. But you ain't great yet, and to be great, you gotta work on your game. You gotta work on your game, man. Don't be sending out tweets with you and your little actress girlfriend riding in your Ferrari. I don't want to see that. I want to see you win a championship for Philadelphia. In certain cities like Philadelphia, Boston, New York, Miami, Dallas, we know what hard work is. And we know what being fearless is. We can see when a person has a guy 6'1" on him, and he drives under the basket to kick it out to another guy when you should have dunked it. That's not what we want. We just want you to work on your game. He's getting a lot of criticism, and it's warranted. All the great players did. It's part of the business. One thing my father taught me, he said, okay, a lot of these people are talking about you. But is your criticism warranted? In this case, it is. He needs to say this. Do I want to be a good player or a great player? Look, you're making $30 million and you got all your Ferraris and Lamborghinis. That's a great life. But do you want to be remembered? Do you want to go down in history? Do you want the great Frank Isola to talk about you like you're one of the greatest things since sliced bread? How do you want to be remembered? Once he can look in the mirror and answer that, his problems will go away, Shaq said about him. Number 5. Draymond Green. While people have often criticized Simmons for his attitude, other players have had his back. They know what it's like to be pointed at and would hate to see Simmons' career altered by the haters. Draymond Green, who's also represented by Clutch Sports, gave him some friendly advice on his birthday, taking to Instagram to try and help him put things into perspective. Man, stop letting these people get in your head, young king. Enjoy your birthday. Basketball ain't got nothing to do with it. So don't let them intertwine life and basketball for you. Enjoy your life and enjoy hoop. You've earned both. You don't owe anybody anything. You've earned everything you have. Happy born day, brother, Green told him. And he sure knows one thing or two about being criticized. Number 4. Luka Doncic. Not so long ago, Simmons was highly touted as one of the players that will lead the new era of basketball. Now that distinction belongs to Luka Doncic, who's got some similarities in his offensive game as a player that can pass the ball like the best of them. I think we're like similar, you know? He can play point guard, he can play forward, he can play a lot of stuff like LeBron, said Doncic before entering the league. Then, a couple of years later, Simmons completely clamped him during one of their games. But Doncic didn't want to credit him for his sound defense on him. I don't really pay attention to who's on me, I just try to play my game. Sometimes I'm gonna play it better, sometimes worse, Doncic said after the game. Number 3. Kevin Durant. It's really hard to blame Daryl Morey and the Sixers for trying to hold on to Ben Simmons or at least get his real value in return. He's young, far from his prime, on a long-term deal, and has a unique skill set that only needs to be polished for him to become one of the best two-way players in the world. All who really know basketball can see that Simmons is just too good at too many things for people to focus on the only thing he's very bad at. In fact, Kevin Durant thinks he's a one-of-a-kind player. He's something that I've never seen before as really playing the point guard. That height, that speed, and that strength. You can tell he's Aussie too. He doesn't mind getting into some scuffles and showing his feisty side. That's going to mean well for the Sixers down the line, said Durant when Simmons was entering the league. Number 2. Joel Embiid. The Philadelphia 76ers built their entire project, or should I say process, based on Joel Embiid and Ben Simmons. They're two generational talents that have proven to be incredibly dominant to the defensive end and pretty much unstoppable on offense when surrounded by the right pieces. Needless to say, that meant that Simmons' relationship with Embiid could make or break the entire process. Throughout the years, there were no indications of an altercation between the two, although analysts believed that they couldn't coexist on the court, and that Embiid would be better off with a scoring guard. Embiid also didn't look very pleased when Simmons decided to pass when he had a wide-open layup in their pivotal game versus the Atlanta Hawks in the second round of the playoffs. I'll be honest, I thought the turning point was when we had an open shot, and we made one free throw and we missed the other. And then they came back and scored, and we didn't get a good possession on the other end, and Trey came back and he made a three, and then from there down four, and then it's on me. I turned the ball over, tried to make something happen from the perimeter, but I thought that was the turning point, Embiid said. That wasn't the first time he seemed to call out Simmons. Years ago, he suggested that the starting lineup's lack of shooting and Simmons' unwillingness to take three-pointers were the reason behind their struggles. We just gotta look at ourselves and see what we can do individually. We've gotta help each other even if it means being outside of your comfort zone for the greater good to help the team win. Meaning that if you've got to space and shoot it, you've gotta do it. We need everybody to buy into that and we'll be fine. We're going to be fine. We're still finding our groove. We haven't been totally healthy, the whole starting lineup. Like I said, we'll be fine. Then again, Embiid has also lauded his teammate throughout the years, claiming that he should have been named Defensive Player of the Year last season, and trying to put an end to the narrative of their rift. Stop using my name to push people's agenda. I love and hate drama. I love playing with Ben. Stats don't lie, he's an amazing player and we didn't get the job done. It's on me personally. I hope everyone's back because we know we're good enough to win. I haven't forgotten, but 2 years ago, I got booed. People in Philly wanted me to be traded. I even shushed them. Only the real ones didn't, but I just put the work in that offseason to be better, because I knew I wasn't playing up to my potential. Philly fans, y'all also gotta be better. For clarity, I love the criticism. I love when I'm told I can't do something. It makes me work harder to prove everyone wrong, but not everyone's built like that, Embiid said on Twitter. Number 1. Danny Green. As we previously mentioned, Simmons' playmaking is one of the best there is, but his defense is one of the main reasons why the Philadelphia 76ers had been a perennial contender over the past couple of years. He's one of the few players in the league who can actually guard 1-5 and play lockdown defense. Needless to say, that's why the Sixers don't want to take a penny on the dollar and trade him at a discount. On that note, Danny Green opened up on how it would impact the team and how it would force him to become the primary defender. It's tough to say, man, because we don't know what we're gonna get back for him. We may get a point guard, we may get wings. That might change a lot. I might be playing with a different type of point guard. I might be playing with different type of wings. I might be coming off the bench. I don't know who we're going to get. Defensively, I'll probably become the primary defender. Not that it's an issue or a problem for me, but we have one less wing defender without Ben. Now it's me and Matisse. Not saying the other guys don't play defense, but you talk about our main defenders, Ben was a big part of that, and a part of our defense. Obviously, Tobias has kicked it up a notch and has been amazing defensively for us, but Ben was Defensive Player of the Year for us this year. Everybody on our team, of course, we thought he deservedly so should have been Defensive Player of the Year. No disrespect to Rudy Gobert, he had a great year as always, and for the last 3 years, but we thought Ben was able to guard 1-5 and set the tone for us. But if he's gone, that changes a lot. Not just offensive, but defensively as well for me. It depends on what we get back in return, Green said when asked about his teammates' desire to leave. Is Simmons ever going to become a good shooter? Will he become a superstar? Let us know in the comments, and don't forget to like and subscribe to get even more top-notch NBA content.